Hanna Dekker. I am running the pantry right now. In the interim, while our other friends that run the pantry are at home safe. So I've taken over to run the pantry Thursdays, Fridays, and Saturdays. We also place our orders on Tuesdays. So today's Thursday, we're waiting for the truck to be delivered from the Greater Chicago Food Depository. On Thursday mornings, they usually typically deliver around 8 a.m. And they load up about 7,000 pounds right here. And our volunteers pull it through this window so we don't have to go up and down the stairs. So we put 7,000 pounds of food through this window. That'll happen in just a few minutes when the truck comes. Once we get it inside, we have volunteers organize it onto carts and then ultimately organize it into bags of each type of area of food. So we do a pasta and kind of like carbs and rice bag. We have a beans and vegetables bag. We have a meat bag. And then we also provide frozen food and fresh vegetables. So all of that will be done today. Tomorrow we'll have some volunteers come in and organize those bags for us. And then on Saturday we distribute. I'm here at about 7:30 in the morning. And there's already a line down the block, all the way down the side of the church. We feed about 100 people in 2 hours, or 100 families. That's about 400 people. And it's absolutely incredible what happens
here.
Our biggest bottlenecks is definitely registration. Right now, during this season, the government and the Greater Chicago Food Depository has cut down on the amount of registration that we need to do. But on a typical Saturday, there's 2 pages that our clients need to fill out. And it needs to have a signature and be done by hand. And then these papers need to be turned into the Greater Chicago Food Depository. And to do that individually, each one takes considerable time.
Sure, we ask them their household size. We sign it for them. We just insert their name. We actually print it. There's no like cursive involved. We print their names here, their addresses, and then the city, the number of children that are under 18, and then the SNAP. This piece of paper is something that we developed when we first started the food pantry. What we ultimately imagined was that this would eventually be nullified by having a digital database. Typically we pay for food from the Greater Chicago Food Depository. It's heavily discounted, but typically we're paying about $1,500 every 2 weeks for it. I want to find a way to be able to do this quicker. Right now I'm counting. It's probably about 40 minutes. I've gotten pretty quick at it because I know what's on the shelves typically, and I know the case sizes of everything or how much is in each case. I'm writing it all out on a piece of paper and then putting it all into an Excel document and then ordering based off of that. And I think that there could be easier ways to do it.
Hi, my name is Sue Horgan and I'm with Exodus World Service. We are a ministry that works with refugees in the Chicagoland area. We actually mobilize volunteers to serve refugee community. Refugees are newly arrived here. They're coming from war-torn countries, and it's hard for them, especially when they first arrive. But even within the first 3, 4, and 5 years, they struggle, oftentimes with food insecurity as well. All refugees are working part-time or full-time, but food is still a constant need and sometimes hard to secure food stamps if they are working. So we are mobilizing our volunteers to serve the refugee community with grocery care packs to let them know that we care about them, that they're welcome here, and that they can be healthy and not worry about food insecurity.